Hi, I'm Mathew Schwartz with Information Security Media Group, and it's my pleasure to welcome Tony Pepper, CEO and co-founder of Egress, to our studios today. Tony, thanks for being here.
Yeah, good to see you again, Matt.
It's my pleasure. We're going to be talking about empowering employees while preventing insider data breaches. And on the data breach front, you've just done some new research. Interesting findings. Hit me with those.
Yeah, so we've spent years and years in the data security space. And for across those years, we've always tracked the number of data breaches that have been taking place. But we've always never really deeply understood, and quite frankly, the market's never really deeply understood, what's causing these breaches of data security. And more importantly, why are they actually going in the wrong direction? Why are data security breaches going up when it seems like investment in IT and IT security is going up as well? So we wanted to commission independently a survey that would look at insider threat and insider breach, because that's where we believe that the core of the problem resides. So we did that, and we released its findings very recently, centered upon why data security breaches take place, centered around the insider breach.
Okay, and what did you find? I mean, when we think insider, we think malicious.
Right.
But then when you look at the history of breaches, so often it's maybe not malicious, maybe it's sloppy, unintentional.
Yeah.
So what were some of the takeaways
from
that study?
You know, it's a great call, right? So insider breach, even as a phrase, needs kind of drilling into. What does that mean? So if you think of an insider breach from our perspective, we think of intentional loss and unintentional loss. So if, as an example, a person in business is either very maliciously or intentionally sharing content that's very sensitive outside the business, very intentionally, that would cause a breach of information security. But on the flip side to that, what about those people in business that are just accidentally sending information to the wrong people and as a result causing a breach of data security? So we wanted to really drill into that. And the findings that bubbled to the surface was quite alarming. But also what we expected to hear, really. So first and foremost, this survey was across both the US and in the UK. So it was 250 CISOs in the US, 250 CISOs in the UK. And we asked both CISOs questions around the perception of risk and the what's concerned around that insider threat. And we also spoke to end users in business too. What was interesting is 95% of CISOs were still deeply concerned by the insider breach, and in particular, 79% were concerned that information was being lost as a result of an accidental send or an unintentional breach of security. So when you look at those headline statistics, straight away that tells you that everyone's concerned about it and it's a problem that's going in the wrong direction.
Were employees having a similar attitude toward the risks to the organization, though?
Yeah, well, it's funny. We have got different responses from employees. It's interesting. If you've accidentally sent information to the wrong person, you know what you know. And the flip side is, you don't know what you don't know, right? So if you've accidentally sent someone to the wrong person and you don't know what you did, if you ask the question, have you ever done that? What are you going to say, Matt?
So
there's a disconnect between people in business believing it's an issue and CISOs who actually have the information, have the report, see whether it's an issue. So first of all, we weren't necessarily surprised to hear that. What we were quite concerned about, though, and actually I think it's something that business needs to take really seriously, is we sort of started to look at a slightly different demographic around that break between accidental loss and intentional loss. Now, intentional loss doesn't necessarily mean malicious. Within intentional, malicious falls part of that. But even if you break intentional loss down into someone that's very maliciously trying to exit content versus someone that doesn't believe they're breaking security policy, but they are intentionally sending information outside of the business, which has not got the appropriate security controls. Now, that was one bit that we thought was really interesting. And an example of that is people in business, in particular the younger generation, believe that the data that they were consuming and working on was actually their data, not the business's data. So actually they were sharing that with their Gmail account, their Hotmail account, intentionally, outside of the business boundaries, without the appropriate protection, effectively an intentional breach of security.
But presumably for productivity purposes, try to get their job done.
Right, and I think it's not, I think people in business have been demonized, Matt. It's the problem is people, and there's a lot of negative press, actually quite frankly led by a lot of the security vendors about people are your problem, people are your biggest risk. Look, the reality is we need to put tools around people to help them ultimately do their job. And there is a small percentage of quite malicious individuals that are there to affect the business, but there's an overwhelming majority of people that want to do the right thing but either aren't provided the tools to do the job. So again, 61% of end users in business are intentionally communicating information out without the appropriate security. And when we drilled into that, it's because many of them found, I'm not given the tools to protect it, or they're not easy to use. So these people, they want to do the right thing, but they can't do the right thing, or they're really busy, they're tired, the pressures of work. So I think what we've got to do as an industry is we've got to wrap technology, we've got to wrap training around individuals to, that helps them be more productive, as opposed to demonizing it, saying it's their fault, and moving everything to the boundary.
And what's the role of machine learning in all of that to help bring the appropriate controls and safeguards in?
Well, it's critical, right? Because machine learning, too many businesses talk about machine learning like it's the all things to all men, right? But in reality is, look, machine learning isn't the thing that's really neat and sexy. Actually, it's how are you using machine learning to solve real business problems. So for us, we use machine learning to effectively look at vast amounts of information, looking at content, looking at context of who you're sharing with, looking at relationships between who Matt typically shares with and who he doesn't. And what we're able to do there is build up anomalies. What doesn't look the norm, Matt? What looks outside of Matt's typical behavior? And then we can play that back to the user and say, hey, Matt, we think this is an error, or hey, Matt, this is sensitive. This needs protection. So machine learning is really the base plate to provide that capability to then serve up protection that's really easy to use.
So toward that more people-centric vision of security that we've spoken about before.
Yeah, so that is our vision. Our vision is around delivering capability around people, not taking people out of the equation, but putting them right in the center of security and awareness, making them very aware that security is there to make their life better, to make them more productive, to help catch any mistakes that they might make, such that, and it's our belief that end users that use our product absolutely rely on our technology to keep them safe and help them be more productive in business. So that's why we believe a people-centric approach is the only way to get true investment on IT.
But as you said, having technology there, knowing it's there as well as an employee as a kind of last line of defense.
Yeah, that's exactly.
Yeah, bringing the encryption to bear when you need.
Yeah, and you know, the whole point around making sure you send information to the right individuals is a big part of it, as we've just talked about, but also making sure that you apply the right level of protection, and you're dead right, that's where the encryption comes in. So if you're gonna protect information that's sensitive, let's use an appropriate level of protection. Is TLS appropriate? It could well be. Is message level encryption appropriate? It could well be. So what we believe with our technology is we're combining both this risk approach to ensuring that information goes to the right people and that we're avoiding mistakes and catching any potential anomalies. And then we're also seamlessly providing that protection of information at rest and in transit.
Well, excellent. Thank you, Tony, for your insights today.
My pleasure, Matt. It's been great talking to you again.
Thank you. You too. I've been speaking with Tony Pepper of Egress. I'm Matthew Schwartz with Information Security Media Group. Thank you very much for joining us.